Aloha and welcome.
The 27th of January,
we've almost made it through the first month. Scary how fast that went. 2024 in this here and now space. And Kaimi and I are going to lead you on another hourish long sound journey with these magnificent instruments and her magnificent presence. And I'm just going to kind of bundle along for the ride. If you've not done this before, the invitation is to find a comfortable space to lay down or sit down where you can not have to move for about an hour. I invite you to silence your phone if you're on the journey. I find it very rude to have it ring when I'm in the midst of journeying out past the stars. But you be you. It's all good. Good speakers are preferable to computer speakers. Headphones are preferable to computer speakers. Computer speakers will work, I guess. The story I make up is that the sound does much better for clearing your energy channels when it's actually interacting with the interstitial tissues of your body. That's where the magic happens. The vibrations cause your interstitial tissues to expand and contract. That produces electricity, which causes flow, unless it hits blockage, in which case you breathe through and help that blockage clear, and everybody's a winner. Intention, my queen always reminds me. Since you will have some energy available, the invitation is to bring an intention into the journey with you. That intention could be anything from self-healing to world peace to communication with whatever spirits you wish, you are aware of, you want to be involved with. Anything else? Oh, when Kaimi and I start, we share three breaths together. Fully exhaling very slowly and completely filling our lungs as far as it's comfortable, and then holding for a couple of seconds before we release. I like to pull my belly back in towards my spine to really clear everything else out. Another hold for a couple of seconds, and then a repeat. We do that three times, and while we do, we grow roots in the Mama Gaia. When this energy moves through your body, sometimes it shakes things up. Sometimes those things, that energy, is nothing that you need to hold on to. Having roots allows you to give that to Mama Gaia, or just have it flow to Mama Gaia, who will transmute it and send it back up to you, or me, or us, or wherever it's needed. The important thing is that if it's not needed for you, let it go. So we grow roots to do that. It also helps keep me grounded so I don't go flying out in outer space and miss it all. Which has happened once or twice. Anything else? Am I missing something? Welcome, my beautiful queen. You shall be assisting us on the journey. We'll go for about an hour. It will get quiet sometimes. That's cool. Just hang in there. When we're actually finished with the journey, I will talk you back into your body. So when it does get quiet, you're invited to either stay out there where you are or check in with your body, see how it's doing, and make sure everything's going well. That's it. Record time, we're getting down. All right. Hi. Thank you. As this sound journey draws to a close, the invitation is to find your breath. No need to change it, just notice where it is. And allow that noticing to gently guide you back home. Noticing first maybe the rise and fall of your chest, or the tickle at the end of your nose, and your breath is such a magnificent beginning to amazing processes in your body. Ones that I forget to notice and be grateful for. You may notice, as you continue to be aware of your breath, that your body is perhaps tired of being still. Maybe your toes want to flex and wiggle just a little bit. Probably your ankles and wrists. You feel like they might be getting a little frisky too. And of course, once all that starts, the whole body wants to join in the party. And maybe stretch just a little bit. Feel back to home. For those of you in the digital world, we bid you a fond adieu. Thanks so much for spending time with us. The invitation, as always, is to drink plenty of fluids for the next 3 or 4 days. This will allow anything that needs to get flushed away to easily go. Usually just a good idea too. I've been told that when your body gets dehydrated, the first thing to get dehydrated is your brain. Okay, that's not true. I was not told that. But I know sometimes when I drink water, all of a sudden the green is back. I can see green better. I know that's got to be some kind of mental process going there. As well, take good care of your emotional space. Get lots of hugs from people you enjoy. Give lots of hugs to people you love. And keep smiling. It's all going to be okay. Really. Really. It's probably all okay right now, even though sometimes it's hard to see. Blessings. We'll see you again next week. If you're on YouTube, smash that like button. Hit subscribe. Couldn't hurt. Might help. Me, anyway.
Mahalo and aloha.
Bye-bye.